$3.3 billion of the budget goes to the pension. Now let's tie that right back into your education. Okay? Where's that money going? When we put money into education, we send it to the school districts. Many of the school districts are putting it into their portion of the pension.
You're getting blamed for whacking them for $1 billion.
Yeah, we didn't do it. And they know it now. Now they're trying to divert it. I didn't replace it, now they're saying. You've got two levels. You've got state funding, and then you have the federal stimulus, one-time funding, right? That one-time stimulus funding, he put into the operating budget of state government. Yet, when they sent the money to the school districts, they told the school district, don't put this into your operating budget. 75-80% of them put it into their operating budget. They all knew it was going away. Everyone knew it was going away. And it went away June 30th, 2011. My first budget, I now am missing over $1 billion of federal money. Not state money, federal money. We put some same money back in, but we didn't have the money without raising taxes. Now I have a choice. Replace what he cut or try and grow back slowly without taxing the people. I took the latter. The problem is that this money here is getting eaten up because of the pensions too. Because we contribute to the pensions, they contribute to the pensions, the school districts.
Doesn't the gas industry do? Don't they figure that an extraction tax is part of doing business to begin with?
Okay, let's talk about doing business. Do they pay taxes? The beauty for me is I'm a prosecutor, the facts don't change. They've paid over $2.5 billion in taxes since 2008. They've also stimulated an economy in a way that we never could have imagined in 2006.
But aren't they paying taxes in West Virginia and Texas and all those places?
But they pay,
and an extraction
but
tax.
But no. They pay different corporate taxes at a lower level. There is a huge ripple effect on anything that happens there. These are a lot of the companies that are paying the taxes too that weren't paying taxes before. So what I see is somebody says, hey, and he's used this term, the golden goose. It's a golden goose. It is. It's delivering a nice golden egg, you know, yearly. You could see this is growing, but we're at its infancy. This doesn't develop overnight. You know, if you want to consider putting a tax on something when we have an established, up and running, long-term industry, that's the time to look at it, not when they're getting started. How many times do we give tax credits to people, KOZ zones to people, to get up and running? Now, I'm never espousing a KOZ zone for the natural gas industry, but I am espousing, let our workers get the jobs, let us get established. It's not because of this, because of the pensions. Well, we need more money. We need more money. My philosophy was we need to control our spending. That's exactly what I've done. What did I tell you that I was going to do in the campaign? Exactly that. Fiscal discipline, limited government, and free enterprise. The people who are mad are the people who are mad because I'm not spending more money. I'm not taxing people more. I'm not taxing industry more, so that they can spend more money.
One of the things that is certainly, you know, agitates a lot of our readers here is their property taxes. Just seem to completely, they go up. And up here in Westmont, 21 straight years, they've increased their real estate taxes. And, you know, we've heard that the gambling revenue would be able to help offset that, and that's just never come to fruition.
Why?
That's why I'm asking.
No, you're the reporters, why?
Because the people in Harrisburg are asleep at
no,
the switch.
No, not at
what
all.
That?
Not at all.
Well, what is
Who's
it?
The first gatekeeper? Municipalities are limited in their property tax. They have a cap, right?
Okay.
That's number one. School districts originally didn't have a cap.
No, they had to go through a referendum, too.
That's right.
And when I walked in the door, they had 12 exceptions of not going through a referendum. We've reduced it to 3 in my administration. With legislation. But what's one of the 3? Pensions. 163 school districts in Pennsylvania today ask for it, and by law we have to give it to them, exceptions, a waiver, because of the pension. So when Mr. Wolf is out there right now saying, well, they're all raising their property taxes because they didn't get enough money from Harrisburg, no, Mr. Wolf, look at the facts. It's because of the pensions. which he doesn't want to deal with. I mean, you see, we continue to give more and more money to school districts. We're trying.
And is that feeding the pension monster?
Some of it, yeah. Okay. Because they're not depending on the school district, you have to answer. Go back and ask your school districts in this area. Did you use any of the money that you got for education to pay pensions? In fact, PSEA one time said, well, it's not going to the classroom. I certainly hope it is, because the teachers receive the pension. And you know, my predecessor did not fully fund the pension the way the state should. I have.
If the Senate passes the property tax in reform, you know, replaces it with what, income tax and sales tax, is that something you'd agree to? You'd sign?
Sure. We have to know that it's revenue neutral, and I think they're telling us it's revenue neutral. We need to fix pensions at the same time, but we need to replace the money that would be lost in a reform of the property tax in order to continue spending at the level that we're at right now. Now, my goal, you know, if we could, let's reduce our spending. I think it's going to be pretty hard to reduce our spending.
Okay,
especially when 500 school districts are the ones that are determining, truly determining, how much they're spending, because
if they negotiate the contract.
Johnson's in Act 47, and I know there's a proposal out there to change that to limit municipalities to 5 years with a possible 3-year extension. And then also with drugs, the report that just came out from Senator Yaw and Senator Wozniak, unfortunately, Camden County was number one in drug overdose deaths during the period looked at 2007 to 2011. If you can just talk a little bit about those two subjects, please.
Let's go with number two first. I'll be real short. We're coming back next week. You remember back in the spring, in May, I put together a task force to look at the heroin issue, heroin and opiate issue. We're announcing all of that on Tuesday. Well, as it applies to Act 47, part of the problem with Act 47 is the underlying cause. What's the underlying cause of Act 47 here in Johnstown? What's the cost driver?
Pensions.
Oh, it is a cost. Yeah.
There's no question.
Always look at that.
Yeah.
Okay? Now, I've been trying to fight the pension battle. We've discussed it. I don't know that we're going to even get the little bit that we're trying to get right now. But I've already announced, and I did it at the Inquirer and announced it again, I'm going to call in my second term right away. A special session on pensions, not just the state pension. We might as well bring in the municipal pension too, because I can tell you all the municipalities have been coming and say, take a look at this.
Sometimes you get the feeling that, okay, you know, we're getting help, we're bobbing along, and there's no real incentive to, you know, to make the hard decisions and get out of it. I mean, so.
Yeah, personally, I really just don't know.
Yeah.
But what I do know is I will bet almost in every municipal issue it's the pensions.
Yeah. Well, we know that's
okay.
a large part of it.
And I suspect it's the same everywhere.
Hey,
Mr. Wolf says he wants a fresh start. What he really wants to do is go back to the days of Edward Dow. And that's exactly what it is. He's going to spend more, he's going to tax more. Talks about the rate of growth in Pennsylvania, rate of job growth in Pennsylvania. And if you really look at how job growth is determined, it's based upon how much you lost and how much you got back during periods of time in small segments. What I know this, we have 175,000 to 180,000 private sector jobs we have filled. Okay? We have 200,000 jobs available that have gone unfilled. Well, we have to fill jobs we already have. If we would fill all of that, if we were able to do it like that, the estimate is our unemployment rate would be below 3. The gateway drug is marijuana. I don't care what any of the advocates out there say. It's marijuana. The Senate passed a bill, right? Senate over the House. To legalize certain forms of marijuana, right? Pretty broad category. I'm a little... amongst, is that the...
sounds good anyway.
You know what I'm talking about.
I do.
That they can pass that, but they can't pass choice and convenience to the people in Pennsylvania when it comes to buying wine and liquor, or wine and beer at a grocery store. Okay? But we know that marijuana is a gateway drug. You see the advocates, oh, it's not a gateway drug. I'm sorry. It is. You just start looking at the problem that you have with opioid, because it's the next step. It's the gateway.